hey man, yeah, I heard about the 6ix9ine situation, man. It's almost kind of like the Bobby Smyrna situation. It seemed like New York, you know, they got the hip-hop police in New York crazy, man. And, you know, with the law, they could bend and finagle stuff to make it fit whatever they wanted to fit. But once the feds come get you, though, they got some type of evidence, yeah, man. And, you know, if they drop that RICO, would still everybody get the same charges type situation? Yeah, but I think a guy like 6ix9ine would tell, though. Because I really think anybody that got all that colorful hair and doing all this stuff to get attention, 69 on his head, and I don't think they really built for it like that, man. I just think he had an image. And I mean, I don't know him. I like him personally. I like that he don't back down and he talks shit. And, you know what I mean? I like him personally. But I don't know him. But I just think that he's going to tell. I mean, but he had
1 mile. Stay to the left to I-95 South, Chester,
Wilmington. Okay, baby. And I just think he had a good career. Like, I see him perform. I like the way he performed. I don't really know his songs like too much. But I seen him performance. His performances was crazy. But if that young guy go to jail for like a long time, man, this could be a wasted talent. Crazy, man. He could have been something special to his neighborhood, because he was successful as hell, fast, out of nowhere, you know what I mean? And it's like, you gotta understand, even though he's Puerto Rican or Mexican, whatever he is, he's still a person of color. You know what I mean? It's like every time if a young boy got that much bread and doing stuff like that, they should get some type of pass. Because rich, when somebody white and rich, they get all type of passes. Did y'all see the situation where it was two black guys and a white guy that did a drive-by and killed somebody? The white guy didn't do no time. He's talking about he didn't know what was going on. He was out of his element. What? I just think sometimes.
Stay to the left to I-95 South, Chester, Wilmington.
But this is what I wanted. This is what I'm curious to see. I'm curious to see if 6ix9ine tell, right, his snitch, will he still have the same amount of fans? That's what I want
to
see.
Continue straight for 7 minutes to I-495 South, Port of Wilmington, Baltimore.
People always tell me nobody don't care about snitching no more. You can snitch, that's cool. So I want to really see for myself, like, is if he tell, will he still be popping how he popping now? And will fans just don't care? Because, I mean, I know it's a new era. I don't belong to this era.
Watch out, construction on road ahead.
But yeah, man, I hope he get free, man. I see a lot of people making jokes about it, man. It's not a joking matter to me. At the end of the day, he's still a young person that had a lot to learn, a lot to live for, even if he wasn't famous. I mean, so it's a sad wasted life if he lose. I mean, if he tell me, he made some money, he better go buy a house somewhere and just fall back. I mean, but I don't think he had the type of personality to fall back, because once you get a taste of that fame, it's addictive. You want it. It's crazy. I never wanted the fame. I swear to God, it always made me nervous. It always just didn't fit me right. I just couldn't be like, you know, like, I just didn't like it. I didn't like people staring at me. I ain't like none of that. You know, but I had to do what I had to do to eat. You know, but 6ix9ine, man, hold your head up. I hope you're free. I hope you don't be telling. I mean, but you know, niggas, they try to do life that has millions on the streets. But you got to stand what you do. But I think they're going to get that nigga special. He rich, so they're going to be like, yo, tell on such and such, such and such, such and such. But if he got it on tape ordering a hit, I mean, what kind of deal can you really get? I mean, shit. Unless you tell them everything. You tell them the nigga that hit you with a snowball in the third grade. You want the nigga that hit you with the snowball in third grade, too. 6ix9ine, don't be doing no telling, man. Come on, man. Stand up. Don't be like Neef. 6ix9ine. Peace. Hold your head.